Well, the storm is finally winding down, and because of that, travel bans on the Skyway and the Thruway will end at 4 a.m. But there's plenty of damage left behind. Our Dave McKinley has that part of our team coverage tonight.
We were warned prior to the storm that it would bring damaging winds, and we found perhaps no more a glaring example of that than down here on Ganson Street near the waterfront.
Because that wall on this grain silo, built in 1897, had withstood nature's fury for nearly 125 years, until tonight, when a section of it was reduced to a pile of bricks not far from where water pushed by a Lake Erie sash up the Buffalo River flooded over the base of warehouses, driven by the unrelenting winds strong enough to bend and topple steel signs along roadways earlier in the day.
What'd you think when you saw?
Pretty bad. It's awful.
When this large tree fell on two houses on Centennial near Jersey, the occupants were able to escape uninjured, but the damage was so bad they could not stay. Their landlord was hoping to help them find other accommodations.
I got a most important thing. I got to, you know, find my tenant to place to live. Yeah. You know, that's the important thing for me right now.
Down trees and power lines were a common sight throughout the city, all on a day when it was hard to walk or for birds to fly, although they weren't the only thing having a hard time navigating the skies.
What are you guys doing out here?
Watching planes land. Try to land, at least.
Eric Tuckles and his son were actually building a model airplane together, and they thought this might be more interesting. But while they were able to see some takeoffs, when it came to landings, pilot after pilot started to make their approach before deciding it was too dangerous, pulling up and diverting to other airports.
Not today. Yeah. They're not even, well, they're attempting, but they're not doing very well, so.
Dave McKinley, Channel 2 News.